Salt and Beans.
Hi.
Playing Dishonored.
Everyone. We've returned.
Returned.
I know you were all waiting with bated breath. What?
Here we go.
Here. Oh, look. We already saw this.
Yep. So we're not even going to go over it. We're going to go to the Hound's Pits pub.
Sheathed.
Okay. So.
Oh, wait, let the cutscene go.
This is the Hound Pits pub, closed for business. Half the district marked off is dead from the plague. We're right under the Lord Regent's nose, and he don't know a thing. Of course, if anyone finds out what we're up to, the Watch will break in with swords drawn. And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent's going to be tearing the city apart. I'll take you up to meet Admiral Havelock and the rest of the Loyalists. The Admiral's a man to be reckoned with. If anyone can help you find that missing girl, Lady Emily, and clear your name, he can.
Thanks, Samuel.
That's my wife creeping by.
For a minute, I thought you were talking about the game. I was like, okay, fine.
Bye. I don't have a dishonored wife.
No one has a dishonored... You don't have a dishonored wife.
I don't.
Okay, let's see. You're not supposed to do this yet, obviously.
What are you doing?
Here. Let's see if I can do this again. Come on.
What are you doing?
There's a little, come on. Oh my god. Just stand up. I don't want to be underwater right now. Stop. There's a crank that you can pull here. If you... Come on.
He really wants to swim.
But he like keeps going underwater. It's like the one control that I really don't know. Okay. Okay. Stop. God. And that means you can get under here earlier than you're supposed to. Come on.
So finicky. You need to go forward a little bit. I can't reach it.
Well, he can reach it anyway. So there's a glitch if you want one.
Why would you want to go down here early?
You don't really have to or anything, it's just fun.
Well, is there anything down here of interest?
I don't know if this has been patched yet, but if you get down here early, oh, I don't think it's here anymore. You fight Weepers down here the next time you wake up, and they aren't here right now, but if you go down here, supposedly, like, when you get down here the next time, there's Bone Charms here, but they're not here right now because it's a script, but this is still here, which is an ancient note, but it looks very modern and has a wax seal and everything. I'm sorry, but I won't be here for the next meeting, or ever again, for that matter. What happened here was unnatural and makes me sick to recall. I left the result of our labors here for you to keep, but I expect that the rats will consume them before you return. Goodbye. And if you're here when you're supposed to be, there's a bunch of bone charms around. I just like being in a place that you're not supposed to be. Walking around in sewage, it's great.
Elsie loves garbage.
I love garbage.
Slide around the garden.
Well, yep, so that's a fancy trick for you guys. If you ever want to get down here for no reason. You also can't even open it up from the outside without the key. Just in case you get down here, I guess.
Why would you want to do this?
It's just fun. Oh, I'm crouching.
What, a coffin?
No, it's a boat.
Oh.
Samuel sleeps in the garbage.
Okay.
The boatman who brings you here sleeps in, like, a garbage pile.
Stay loyal.
Thank you.
What is that?
That's a door. That's the one you come down here by. It's really stupid because you wake up and they're like, oh, there's weepers down in the sewers. Can you get rid of them? Which doesn't really make much sense. Why wouldn't they just go in and get them?
Because they have to introduce weepers somehow.
And the weepers are not zombies at all. They're still people.
Well, they act like zombies, so they basically are zombies.
I suppose gameplay-wise they are, but they are not. This is where Sam sleeps. In here.
Why doesn't he have, like, a room?
I think they tried giving him a room, but he doesn't want one. Oh, take that.
Just steal from him.
Mm-hmm. Mystery is a Pandicia. So it's an excerpt from a book on the continents, Pandicia. So right now, Gristal and the islands are actually like an archipelago of islands off of a continent called Pandicia. It's a great big continent, so kind of like Pangaea, and we're just living on the outskirt islands now.
Oh, so that's where Dunwall is?
Yes, Dunwall is on an island outside of Pandicia.
Oh, okay.
And there's a bunch of other ones, and Cirkonos is one of the island countries, and it's kind of like Greece, Cuba put together. It's a hot climate island, and that's where Corvo's from.
Corvo?
Yeah, so he's not native to Dunwall. So excerpt from a book on the continent Pandicia. At the Academy of Natural Philosophy, they speak the Pandician continent as a place of wonder, where all of life has entwined and blossomed across aeons, producing a vibrant ecology unrivaled in civilized world. The overseers from the Abbey of the Everyman, by contrast, talk of horror and heresies, of cults of submen engaged in brutal, perverse rituals. The few who have traveled to the far continent and come back with the Isles, those who have actually touched the soil there, have returned with notes that describe vast deserts, deep jungles, and outlandish creatures that defy belief. Once in a generation, a great effort is mounted to build a colony there, in hopes of this someday growing into a part of the rival city of Dunwall itself, but to date, these attempts have all ended in madness and failure. And this is because Pandicia is filled with horrible heat. Yeah, so it's kind of like, you know, the inverse of Australia. So you know how Australia became like a smaller island continent where a bunch of creatures that were super poisonous and shit lived? Well, I guess the inverse happened here. The island was less poisonous, and the continent, which is huge, is filled with terrible creatures.
Cool.
So that's some neat trivia for you.
I expect they're hard at work in there. Best join them.
Do you think Corvo
They'll help
smokes?
You get whoever
oh, no, he does
kill
smoke.
The Empress.
He does?
Yeah, he does smoke. I know that for a fact because he and Jessamine, when they had time off, would smoke cigars and have whiskey together.
How do you know that?
There's like a secret room, and she writes about it.
Oh.
So.
Huh.
I know that for a fact. He does smoke. And I think, I'm not sure if I remember this right, but in the outro, if you get the low chaos ending, he's shown smoking at the Hound Pits with Samuel and drinking.
Cute.
Violators will be taken to the flooded district.
Yeah, so he does smoke.
And rehabilitation.
He's probably aching for a smoke right now.
Give me a cigarette.
He like just got out of prison. He's like, please, please, please give me a cigarette.
Sign language is desperately.
I think that would be like that would be one of the things though because
have you ever killed a man?
Okay, so this is obviously not That's true anymore point, because so. Of the second game where he has voice acting. But I always felt like when I played the game, I always thought it would be great if he were either mute or deaf. I guess it doesn't really matter. And he used sign language.
Yeah, we talked about this.
Yeah, I know, but I think it's fine to go back in it in depth.
Yeah. No, I'm just saying, like, they know that your headcanon is that he's...
Well, I mean, it depends on who's watching it.
I guess,
Can you look up the seven scriptures?
Sure, why?
Because I want to know which one I'm thinking of. It's like the wagging tongue or something. I always forget what it is.
Dishonored.
Yeah, but one of them is something about not being able to talk. And which, so it would make a lot of sense if all of their maids, their security, you know, people who would be in not exactly nobility, but probably within the abbey or worked for the abbey, like it would be something that they would.
It's a lying tongue.
It's lying tongue. Yeah, I mean, you don't even have a tongue to talk with, quote unquote. So it would be something that would probably be sought out for. And I mean, if your maid can't hear what you're saying, she's obviously not going to be able to talk to anyone, quote-unquote, about it. I mean, of course they do, but I just think that would be great if there was, like, this really big sign language community. But of course, no one outside the Abbey or people who don't work.
We can continue this later, Lord Pendleton. The man of the hour is here. Corvo, I'm Admiral Havelock, a true servant of the Empire, like you. Until the Lord Regent purged those of us who wouldn't recognize his claim on the throne.
And I'm Lord Trevor Pendleton. I represent the nobility in our little group. But we all act as equals here at the Hound Pits pub.
This is a momentous occasion, Corvo. I'm going to come out with it. We've been building a coalition of loyalists, aimed at ending the Lord Regent's tyranny and restoring the throne.
At risk of execution, like we're committed to finding young Lady Emily and seeing her crowned as Empress.
Mm-hmm. We've got big plans. But we can't do any of it without you. We need your skills, your ability in a fight. And in helping us, we're going to help you destroy the men who murdered the Empress.
Sorry, you must be exhausted. We can discuss this further after you've recovered. But before you retire, you should introduce yourself to Piero. He's challenging at times, but his industrious mind buys him that right.
Yes. Piero's as much an artist as a technician.
Can I have that?
He's going to be crafting the gear you'll need. Go talk to him and then get some sleep. We can talk more when you've rested.
Anyone with information leading yeah, I'll talk to you when I'm rested, all right. Yes. Come on. Eat. Yes. He's like watching me. Just chow down. I think that was a tin of jellied eels.
Ew.
I feel like the food, it's island food, right? And we've discussed this. A lot of islands like Iceland and Japan or like outer reaches have quote unquote weird food. But I feel like it's just like,
well, it's food that's accessible.
Yeah, it's food that's more easily accessible. Like there's the food, there's a dish where you just eat an entire lamb head. Remember
in
that?
In Iceland, yeah, I know, yeah. Yeah,
you just drop it into the water and... But, oh, he's in here. So that's not gonna work out. You can... I want to listen to everyone's, read everyone's personal diaries, peeling wallpaper. I'm not sure this place has passed an inspection.
Corvo's here to inspect it.
Yes! Yes. If you get this key, it means every single door is unlocked to you, which is pretty nice.
Why wouldn't you get that key?
Some people miss it.
Oh.
So they don't go looking, they just like, you know, go for the objective.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, but no, I feel like jellied eels, and there's like a bunch of other weird foods that you can find.
You're not gonna listen to that thing?
I will, but I want to talk about starvation food for a minute. It's because they live on an island, so a lot of their weird food is because they live on an island.
I mean, I guess, yeah.
I mean, I bet Pandicia is filled with delicious food. But,
I mean, nobody lives there, it seems.
No, I think there's, I don't remember, but I do think that there are, like, groups of people who live there.
Yeah, I mean, I guess people could live there that they don't know about.
Yeah, they just don't know about it, because I feel like they're extremely xenophobic, and they're like, no, we're the only country, we're the best, you know, really.
Yeah.
Like that. But I don't think so.
Log entry 1-4. It seems we've moved to a new phase. Martin's improvisations have borne fruit. The former bodyguard has been freed and is en route to the staging location. Pendleton's voting block and my military connections. All we've lacked is the ability to project lethal force in a controlled manner against a previously inaccessible... To the point, we need a man who can kill the bastards for us. Corvo is more than capable of that, I have no doubt. End ball.
Corvo will kill no one.
Switch, where the hell is the...
Turn it off!
Yeah, something funny about this. I think this is... You only hear his autograph once or twice because he gets annoyed with it and throws it in the river. And then Samuel finds it and starts using it. So that's something funny. Okay, Havelock's log. I love reading his diary. It has been days since our men were dispatched to stash weapons for Corvo in the old sewer. They have not returned, so I can only hope that they succeeded in getting the packages delivered. Piero spent considerable time and resources making those things. If I could find any way to mass produce them, the Dunwall Navy would secure its place as the dominant force of the globe. But back to Corvo. Can he actually break out of Coldridge? And if so, will he make his way here? I personally give him I give him odds of 1 out of 5. Well, I made that odd.
That's really rude.
He's a very rude man. Oh, steal that. A Gaffer's Tale's not really something that you need to read for the plot, so.
But world building is fun.
It's not world building.
What is it?
It's just a book. I don't want to read this whole thing. Yeah, it's a journal of a young whaler. I mean, to paraphrase, he goes on a sailing trip and his life kind of sucks. There. Okay, excerpt from a book on naval history. So this is world building. While each of the isles has some form of naval fleet, none is more envied than that of Gristle, with its long, proud history of great ships and the admirals who command them. Boys come of age in the cities of Gristle hoping to someday captain such a ship, and family dynasties are made by those captains who track down infamous pirates or crush seditious uprisings, as in during the Morley insurrection. Morley is a different island.
Okay.
In times of war and peace, Gristle continues to innovate at sea. The ship designs of Anton Sokolov himself now represent the highest standard in the whaling trade, allowing crews to haul their kill up over the deck and begin their butchery and processing even as the ship returns to Dunwall. The crews can be seen working on their latest whale as the ship moves slowly up the Renhaven River, coming to dock with one of the powerful warehouse companies, such as Greaves Whaling House. Suspended in the rigging overhead, the backlit by the setting sun, the silhouette of one of these creatures makes a moving sight as it cruises to its final resting place in the industrial heart of the capital city. So yeah, obviously whale oil is the kind of processing oil that this world uses to power all sorts of things. And they do it by processing live whales, obviously. Hi.
Wallace.
If I may, I am the personal assistant to Lord Pendleton, and one of the senior servants at Pendleton House, as was my father. Now I am entrusted with this house, the home of the Loyalists. I have never seen the Admiral fail at any venture. If order can be restored to the city of Dunwall, I believe he can do it. If anyone can get your old life back, it's him.
Thanks.
I like his coat.
I like his coat also. Why is his hands so big?
Everyone in this game has huge hands.
I know, they're giant. Are you still in here?
Yeah, he's chilling.
Okay.
You're gonna eat his pie.
Oh, he's gone.
Pleased to meet you, Master Corvo. I saw you at court in happier days. But you might not remember. I was once a close ally to the Lord Regent, Hiram Burrows. Back when he was just the spy master. He's one manipulative bastard, I can tell you that.
Why are you looking at him like that?
His hands are also huge.
Yeah, I told you, everyone in this fucking game has
you
the
think
biggest...
He has... I'm gonna listen to this right in front of him.
My furnishings have been installed at last with no small amount of complaining by that antiquated boatman. The others have no idea what it's like to suffer as I have. Speaking of which... Wallace! Please breathe 2 bottles of Dunwall Red, never mind which, and fetch a clean glass. Well, I'll begin again tomorrow.
It's just the style of the game. Like, everybody has huge hands.
I know.
It's really... really weird. Why would he put that under his bed?
He didn't see me do it.
Do they care? Do they care if you steal their stuff?
No.
Then what are you worried about?
But it's still funny to take without them looking.
Bunk beds.
River traffic is forbidden from landing in the distillery district due to risk of infectious contact. Violators will be taken to the flooded district for treatment and rehabilitation.
Yeah, it always pays to look around because items actually switch around all the time. Hello.
Lydia.
My, you must be Corvo. I am Lydia, at your service. Your room is upstairs and
ready. Thank you.
When they told me who it was, well, I thought you'd be older, like the Admiral.
How old is Corvo?
I always forget how old he's supposed to be, but I always imagine... Can I take that? I always imagine that he's, like, somewhere in his 30s.
I thought he was, like, older. Apparently he's younger.
I thought he was reasonably aged. Not, like, ridiculously young. But, you know, not in his 50s or anything.
He's actually 90.
Yeah, he's actually 92 years old.
Do not attempt to house or care for a friend
Sorry, Lydia,
or family
I'm just
member
inspecting the premises.
Who shows signs of blood on their face and
Isn't
chest
that a bathroom?
Area. The yes. only way to help them is to bring them to the city watch. They will be taken to the flooded
Shall
district for treatment.
The young prince of Tivia. I like how they have, like, reading material for the loo.
Well, yeah, you gotta,
I think at some point, I don't know if it is this bathroom. This is one thing I'm not gonna spoil. Something happens in this bathroom. Just be polite, Corvo, close the doors behind you.
Is this where Piero is?
No.
Where is he?
Give me a second. Pierre is outside. And he talks
Attention
about how great he is and
be advised,
how much
the river
of an inventive mind
infestation
he is
has spread downriver as far as the river mouth and flooded
Oh, yeah.
District. Do
You're
not
currently maskless.
I'm currently maskless, Rongor.
Any items recovered from doing so are considered state property.
Mm-hmm. He's over there.
Oh, yeah.
That would really hurt if he smacked his head right on that.
Can you, like, just please imagine Corvo falling from that balcony and smacking his head against that?
I mean, he probably would. I can't. It's like one of the things I can never get over that he just escaped from prison, and they're like, do you want food? No, they don't ask for that. They're like, you don't want new clothes? They don't ask for that. They're like, hey, we need you to kill people for us.
He's like, all right.
He's like, I don't want to. Like, when they're like, oh, we need to get Emily and restore her to the throne. I feel like his first thought was, no. I'm gonna get Emily and we're gonna leave.
Fuck this place.
Yeah, I'm gonna get Emily and we're just going to go. Not here. Okay.
I'll be crafting your weapons and gear. All custom work. For you, I will create the tools of a master assassin. No! This cannot happen now. The tank of whale oil's run out. Will you get a new tank from upstairs, please, while I hold this in place? Be careful. The oil's unstable. When it explodes, there's a terrible mess.
I think he, like, had something planned out. He was gonna, like, do a little show. He's like, no, this can't happen now!
That one is empty. A new tank.
Okay. Piero's request is denied.
Aww.
So Piero is our local inventor and...
Local?
Yeah, our local inventor. And he needs a bunch of weird stuff. And you can actually collect that stuff for him. Like King Sparrow feathers and stuff. So, no, I will not sign off on these purchases. A bag of powdered crystal, Tivian ore. What's wrong with the metals and crystal? King Sparrow feathers? If you need feathers, sacrifice your own pillow. Maybe at the academy everything you needed was paid for by tariff and handed out willy-nilly. But this is my bar, or what's left of it, and we'll be operating on a budget. We're running low on oil, food, elixir, building materials, and everything else, so you've got to slow down. While I'm on footing the bill, I will not approve your purchases unless they're absolutely required. No more copper wire or special herbs. If you need those things, go out and scavenge them. Half the city is in ruins, so no one's going to miss any of the odd crap you seem to need. And that's from Havelock. so, that you know, medicinal herbs, the feathers, and... Oh, here we go. It is jellied eels.
Ew. Sounds so gross.
It's one of Corvo's favorite foods.
Is it?
I don't know, but it is now. You can use this for no reason. It never comes in handy.
I wonder why they would put in, like, the work of allowing that to be moved.
Actually, at some point there is a, vise that's holding a bone char and you have to, like, open up to get it out. Okay, take that. I almost forget what this is. Okay, let's see here. So this is how the whale oil tanks work. One of the advantages of Sokolov Technologies is that they share the same magnetic socket for the tanks of processed whale oil that they use as fuel. When a tank is exhausted, another one can be plugged into place with ease, and the process is simple enough that any common workman or even lower guardsmen of the city watch can handle the task. This applies to the arc pylon and wall of light security systems, as well as the powered carriages used for transfer by those few who are wealthy enough to afford them. The only obvious downside of Sokolov's design is the vitality of the tanks themselves. A few incidents have occurred resulting in damage to property or bodily harm whenever one of the tanks has exploded. So that's kind of a hint that you shouldn't be throwing them around because they do explode.
Oh, he also tells you not to throw them around.
Well, yeah, but just in case it wasn't obvious enough. Oh, here's his door to Norway. This is his portal reference. Sokolov no longer has the upper hand with regard to supplies of whale oil. The good admiral has paid for the installation of my own system, which will enable me to work in this place. So this is written by Piero. The oil tank dispenser, when activated, will produce the empty vessel for filling. Oh, right, that's this thing. It just tells you how to use this, so you can dispense a tank.
Isn't this like the only time you have to do this?
No, because you can use tanks within, against enemy guards.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to kill them.
Not always. Oh, where'd that coin go?
Did I already pick it up? Yeah, you already picked it up.
Yeah, I don't want to. Let's see. Well, with the section. I want to see his door to nowhere. Where is it? Whale oil processing. This is pretty much like a cache of whale oil BS if you want to read it. Trunk, he doesn't have anything. He's poor. Dead counter responsibilities, failed experiments. Well, let's get on with that.
You don't want to read any of them?
Not right now. We kind of crammed a lot of stuff in here. Let's get on with another cutscene.
Yeah.
Perfect. Now plug it in. Just get it near the receptacle. Magnetism will do the rest. Perfect. Thank you, Cole. Here. See?
I've used one of these before. The I live here mask. In Dunwall.
You're a wanted man, so everyone in the city knows your face, but this mask will mean terror to them. If you just hold still.
Why did he have to make it so freaky?
There.
1 second.
Can you see normally? Send the lens out of alignment. There. Better now? I could create more for you. Upgrades for your gear, weapons, munitions. But our situation here is desperate. Scavenge the city for valuables and I will resell them on the black market. That should give us the money to craft the things you need. Tell me what I can make for you. I advise that
yes.
You get some sleep.
Yes.
Your life will get even more difficult soon. You should rest while you can.
What do you know about my life?
Very well. You know best.
Let me know if you need anything more.
Yeah, another thing that everyone has complained about is that everyone's trying to impose a bedtime on you. It's daylight. Let me run around. Go to bed, Corvo. Who wrote this? It was someone here who wrote this. Also, I think it's kind of funny. They're like, we can't let anyone know we're here, but the bellows are on.
Is that part of the pub?
Yeah, this is part of the... This is part of the... Hound Pits Pub. The Hound Pits. This is for, like, dog bedding. And it's right... It's that same building.
Oh.
And this is the pub that's attached to it. So you go here, you get your drink, you talk to your buddies and your pals, and then you go over here to watch the dog fights. It's all one place.
Huh.
Labyrinthian. There you are. Sorry about stealing your map.
I once served under Admiral Havelock. Captain Havelock then. I don't know if he remembers me, but I fear it's rude to ask. I don't want to embarrass him.
All right, I'll ask for you. He doesn't understand sign language, so.
You don't think he does?
Havelock doesn't know. I mean, I kind of feel like Havelock doesn't.
Don't do that, it'll make people dizzy.
It makes you dizzy.
Also me.
Is there anything else I can eat? Coins.
People are really careless with their money in this place.
Right?
Lady Emily Caldwin was abducted 6 months ago during her mother's terrible murder. Anyone with information leading to the location...
You've met Pierre. Good. Of our beloved late You'll want to get some rest.
What just happened?
You'll be needed soon.
Why does he watch me?
What just happened?
I don't know. I'm hoping the money reset. Let's take a look. I think maybe the game thought I hadn't gone through the cutscene yet. But I have. I've done it already.
Lord Pendleton's servant, Wallace, awaits you upstairs. He can show you to your chair.
I like how that paper is floating.
Sleep well.
Okay, well, before we go upstairs and I, have some dream time.
Some dream time?
Time. Is the...
Go up to your room.
Is the man dangerous?
Yes, very much so, but no need
is
to
the...
fear. He is here to work.
Go up to your room.
People say he killed the Empress.
Of course he didn't. People are foolish and believe whatever they're told.
Okay. If the Admiral trusts him, then so will I.
What's up? Hey,
just lean out. Excuse me.
Hey, it's me, Corvo.
Hey.
Heard you talking about me.
I didn't kill my wife. Right, so,
room!
It's not my bedroom yet.
Oh.
Not yet.
This is your
it's
living
here.
Room.
Corvo's chambers!
Chambers!
The dining room. Okay. More money. For me. Very spacious. No kitchen. No bathroom up here either. Another one. Yeah, well, once you lay down here, you do have some quality dream time. So we're gonna pick up later on, and we'd like to thank you for watching.
Thanks.
Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff.